First at 4, a local father standing up for his son.
The 8th grader is suspended and his father is fearing expulsion after a butter knife ends up in his lunch bag at school.
Now, the father says he was told a butter knife is a weapon just like any other knife. WESH News' Dave McDaniel has the story. First at 4.
The 8th grader's father admits that his son should not have had a knife on campus, butter knife or otherwise. But he also believes that the discipline should not be over the top for what he describes as an innocent mistake.
I would be more afraid of an ink pen or...
Chris Ray says his wife packed their son Skyler's lunch on Friday and made a mistake.
Unfortunately, it was packed by dear old mom, but it was with a whole set, fork, knife, spoon.
He says when Skyler used the knife to pry the lid off some pineapple, he sliced his thumb on the can, not the butter knife. But once school administrators got involved, he felt things got out of control.
Skyler was going to be suspended for 10 days, and that everything was going to the school board for review, that there would be a hearing, and that they were recommending that he be expelled for the remainder of the year and placed at the Seminole County Alternative School. The school was referring to it as a weapon, and it can't look good going into college that you got expelled from school for bringing a weapon.
He agrees his 8th grader should not have had the knife, but he says a threat of expulsion was unfair and over the top. Once we started calling the school district, he says he received calls of a different tone, that once it was fully investigated, they could make a case for another chance.
I spoke with the director of middle school education, and while she concedes that any knife on campus is a violation of policy, she says there is wiggle room for administrators to do a rational and thoughtful decision, to meet with students and their parents to make sure the behavior is not repeated and that the punishment is appropriate. Reporting in Seminole County, Dave McDaniel, WESH 2 News.